Today's webinar is basically about studying medicine in abroad locations, especially in the American countries and American continent. Over the past few years, medicine has remained to be the most sought after field of study. Indian aspirants choose to study MBBS abroad for their low-cost nature and the international exposure they gain during their tenure, which is incomparable. By the end of this webinar, you will come to know the valuable insights of studying medicine in America, American countries, and how to fulfill your dreams to become a successful doctor in the United States. Now, from all the participants, I would like to know, if we talk about studying medicine in America or particularly studying medicine in US, can anyone tell what is the procedure to get enrolled to the medical schools in US? You can have your response in the chat box, please. I'll guide you with the procedure and the other terms and conditions, what factors basically are required to get enrolled, especially into the US, and if not in US, what are the options in and around the America countries itself? If we talk about studying medicine in US, there are few factors that you must know, especially in the US medical schools. You should start thinking or you should start preparing for the US medical schools once you are into the high school level. Once you are into the 9th or 10th standard, then itself you should start preparing for your US medical school's enrollment or admission procedures. Few facts basically about studying medicine. In US it is termed as MD, while in India it is termed as MBBS. So I would rather termed it as MD program itself, Doctor of Medicine. These are the few factors, facts about studying medicine in USA. First and foremost, your English command should be very good. Your IELTS scoring, that should be 7+ band in each and every section. Apart from that, there is a SAT exam to get enrolled for the UG course in the United States colleges or the universities before going to the MD program. Because it's not directly like India, after completing the 12th, you can enroll in directly into the MBBS program. In US, you have to go through with the UG course for 3 to 4 years at least, depending on the universities and the colleges. There are the durations difference, and with bio as a major subject. After clearing your 12th and appearing SAT exam, which is an aptitude test, plus also passing the IELTS exam, you get enrolled for the UG course. Once you clear with the UG course, 3 to 4 years of your duration bachelor's program, then you get basically prepare for the MCAT exam. You pass this MCAT exam. MCAT exam is basically the medical college admission test, which is being conducted for getting enrolled into the MD program in US medical schools. While going through with the MCAT scores and your UG scores, the eligibility is being decided for getting admission into the MD program. MD program is again for 4 years. So overall, you will have to go through with this 4+4 years of the basic medicine graduation course, UG course for 4 years and MD program for 4 years. The cost approx will be 40,000 to 50,000 USD per year. It almost basically comes around to 2 crore in and around only for the MD course in the United States. But again, after completing the bachelor's MD program, you have to start thinking about your residency program. Residency program is nothing else but the PG course. Like in India, there is a PG NEET exam being conducted after the MBBS course. Same in USA, there is basically a residency term being given to the post-graduation course for the medicine. And for that particular course, again, you will have to go through with the USMLE exam. As far as USMLE exam is concerned, it is being divided into 3 steps, step 1, step 2, and step 3. Especially when you are preparing for your MD program, in the meantime, you should start preparing for your USMLE examinations. USMLE examination, step 1, that you can appear after your MD1 and MD2. Once you clear your 2 years of your MD course, you can appear for the USMLE step 1 exam. And after that, USMLE step 2, which is being combined with CK and CS, clinical knowledge and clinical skills, you can appear after completing your MD4, that is 4 years of your MD program. Now comes for the PG studies. Some facts, these are some facts which are being related to the studying medicine PG in USA, and some introductions about the PG course. In the American system, as I have mentioned, residency is the collective name for the postgraduate medicine education. It lasts from 3 to 7 years, depending on specialty, whether you want to become a surgeon, whether you want to become a physician. Obviously, the durations difference will be there. If you want to become a neurosurgeon or something, it goes to somewhere around 6 to 7 years of studies. Like in India, it directly starts 3 years of PG program after completing your PG NEET exam and getting enrolled into the PG colleges. In US, as I mentioned, you have to clear the USMLE step 1, USMLE step 2, CK and CS. Then basically you start searching for this PG residency matching courses in the US hospitals. As far as first year of post graduation is concerned, it's totally an internship course of your MD program. Your PG course starts from PG 2, second year of your PG, and then it goes on to PG 3, PG 4, PG 5, PG 6, according to the number of years of education. For example, as I've mentioned, PG 2, PG specialty training, it starts from the second year of your post-graduation. Now we'll come to know what are the factors that you easily or somehow can crack or get a match towards the residency program. What are the main factors basically that affects for getting enrolled into this PG course? These are the 10 major factors influencing successful residency match. As far as USMLE exam is concerned, I have already told that you need to clear USMLE step 1 by the time you are ending your MD2 second year of your MD program. Apart from that, specialty specific letter of recommendation and medical student performance evaluation that are being provided by the medical schools, different medical schools to the body, accredited body, basically who is conducting this USMLE exams. Then comes USMLE step 2 CK, which is again a theoretical exam, and CS, a practical exam, basically clinical skills that is being conducted in the US hospitals. Apart from that, grades in required clerkships, grades in clerkship in desired specialty, what you have earned in MD course, your personal statement, why do you want to join this particular specialty or specialization, your class ranking in the MD course, any failed attempt in USMLE. Be clear about that. If you are going to prepare for this or if you are going to attend that USMLE exam, be very much sure then only you should appear for this USMLE exam. Unless until you are not sure for yourself, it's better to not appear in next attempt. Evidence of professionalism and ethics that are being provided by the university where you are studying your MD course, and fluency in language spoken by your patient population. Now, here comes what Texila American University provide you an advantage for PG residency, getting enrolled into the PG courses, helping you into the matching in the PG residency course. As far as Texila American University is concerned, factor 1, as I have clearly mentioned, the main step is the USMLE step 1 score. The inbuilt USMLE training from first year for all the TAU, Texila American University students, we provide irrespective of whether you want to pursue your PG from US or you want to come back to India and practice here itself. We provide all the USMLE training, all the USMLE preparations to all the Texila American University students. As far as passing ratio is concerned, 96% USMLE step 1 pass rate is there, because unless until we are not very much sure student can clear in first attempt itself, we do not allow the students to appear for this USMLE step 1 exam. As far as TAU exit exam is concerned, all the exit exam for all the subjects right from the pre-med to MD4, these examinations are being conducted in accordance with NBME. NBME is basically a National Board of Medical Examination, which conducts the USMLE examination, which prepares the papers for the USMLE examination. And the same body conducts all the main examinations of Texila American University final year subjects, all the subjects. As far as the curriculum is concerned, the curriculum is being accredited by the LCME. LCME is Licensing Committee on Medical Education in partnership with Ponce Health Sciences University, which uses US curriculum at core of academics. Second factor comes to the specialty specific letter of recommendation and medical student performance evaluation. As I've mentioned, this is being provided by the medical school dean where you have pursued your MD course. Through that particular medical school, your dean provides these letters to the USMLE governing body. Your academic relationship with the faculty specialist ensures that student abilities are known. and he can go ahead with this PG residency in the United States. Alumni of Pons Health Sciences University practice in all 50 states of United States of America, and through their academic partnerships, we also are providing the number of students in PG residency day by day, it's basically increasing. Rotations within USA ensures rotations. I'll brief you about the clinical rotations on the later on stage when I'll go through with the program structure of Texas American University. Rotations within USA ensures that students' abilities are known to the consultants and directors, because you have the exposure of that particular hospital, US hospitals, US directors, US doctors, US consultants, and that give you a more weightage in getting PG residency matches. Third factor is fluency in language spoken by your patient population. As far as US is concerned, the 50.6% of the total number of US students enrolled in foreign language courses take Spanish. Spanish is one of the most spoken language in the United States. As far as TAU is concerned, Spanish is taught to all students of TAU and are prepared for level 2 examination. Level 2 examination, which is being conducted by different embassies in Guyana, available there. Fourth factor is USA clinical rotation and residency guidance. Unless and until you don't know how to do the, basically how to appear for the examinations, how to get through with the matches and other things, it's not an easy task. A normal person cannot even go through with this task, because it needs a proper guidance from the faculties, from the doctors, from the professors across in and around the areas who are basically PAS, who are practicing there. And in that, TAU has an advantage. They have their clinical assistance office in New Jersey, USA, which provides clinical exposure in US. Clinical exposure is basically your clinical rotations of your fourth and fifth year of your MD program, bachelor's program, which is a major advantage. Guide in residency match, selection of specialization based upon historical match trends. Basically, what is the trend going on? You should know. These basically are guidance which is being provided by the TAU's clinical assistance. Selection of cities with higher match chances. Which city has the higher match chances? Which city has the lower match chances? According to that, they suggest you, they help you to apply in that particular city or in that particular hospital in US for PG residency. And fifth factor, evidence of professionalism and ethics. TAU uses a flipped classroom model. Flipped classroom model is basically that particular model in which student can consume lectures, materials according to their own pace. The teacher is present while students apply new knowledge, critical thinking, identical learning. In India also, we have seen the new education policy coming in, wherein more focus is being given to the practical exposure instead of the theoretical, what we were going through since last so many decades. 71% of teachers who flipped their classes noticed improved grades. Now we come to the Texila American University, Guyana on campus. Texila American University is located in Guyana. Guyana is a land country, although it's of Caribbean group, but it's a proper land country in the South American continent. If we talk about America, it's not only US, it's not only Canada, it's not only other countries. Even the smaller countries like Guyana, Brazil, Argentina, these are all comes under the American continent itself. As America is divided into North and South American continent, so there are different countries in different parts. As far as Texila American University, Guyana is concerned, it was established in 2010 and is regarded as top private university in the Caribbean region in South American continent, and recently celebrated its sixth Doctor of Medicine graduation program. As far as affiliations and memberships are concerned, National Accreditation Council of Guyana has recognized Texila American University and the Department of Education has recognized all the registrations, all the enrollments, because we have to keep informing these National Accreditation Councils in that local country. As far as the Medical Council of Guyana is concerned, Texila American University is recognized by the Medical Council of Guyana, a regulatory body, same like in India, Medical Council of India is there. So same in that particular country, Medical Council of Guyana is a regulatory body formed to enhance and monitor the functioning of the medical fraternity in Guyana. World Directory of Medical Schools it's basically a directory of medical schools which maintains the list of all medical schools across the world with accurate, up-to-date and comprehensive information on each school. DAU is listed in WDMS. As far as ECFMG is concerned, Texila American University is approved by the ECFMG that evaluates the readiness of the international medical graduates to acquire residency or fellowship programs in the United States. Like if you have to go through with the USMLE exam, you need to get through the ECFMG certification after completing the second step of USMLE exam, CK and CS. Then you need to get the ECFMG certification and you can apply for the residency positions available in the United States. Texila American University is listed in Medical Council of India. It's recognized and it's under the Act of Indian Act 1956, Section 4A and 4B. If we talk about the College of Medicine of Texila American University, it offers Doctor of Medicine program and Pre-Med program. The medicine program at Texila American University, Guyana is one of the most prestigious programs that the university offers. Students from across the Caribbean region and also from the Indian states and the other part of the world, they want to study there. And with the excellence of curriculum and teaching methodology, they prefer to go with the Texila American University. A career in medicine presents exciting and challenging opportunities, and this is where it all began. As far as faculty is concerned, Texila American University has a diverse academic milieu with faculty coming from across the world, representing a vital teaching and training component of the university. If we talk about the Doctor of Medicine program, as I have termed, there the MBBS program is being termed as MD course, whether in US, whether in the American continent, or some part of other countries in the world. So it's being termed as Doctor of Medicine. It's a 5 years program. It includes pre-medical of 1 year, pre-clinical of 2 years, and clinical rotations, which I was talking about, for 2 years. During the first year, students focus on basic science. As far as second and third year are concerned of the MD course, MD1 and MD2, students focus on basic medical sciences under direct supervision of qualified professors. These professors, basically, as I have mentioned, are from the different part of the world. They are qualified doctors. They are qualified basically educationists who teach the students in the campus. The last 2 years will focus on clinical rotations in affiliated hospitals, whether you can do the clinical rotations in the Guyana itself or you can go with the US hospitals. I have already mentioned Doctor of Medicine. It's a 1+4 year program. Structure is full time. You need to be 12th pass, which you have already done. I hope so all of you have cleared your 12th exams by this now and with good numbers. Age is 17 to 25 years, not a gap, not more than 3 years. Education gap, if you have cleared your 12th in 2017, it's okay. But you have cleared your 12th in 2014, 15, and if you are applying now, then it won't be possible. You should be a NEET qualified because as per the NCI guidelines, if you are going abroad for any of the medical education, you should be a NEET qualified. If you talk about the resources, the laboratories, the labs, medical school provides every kind of resource needed by medical students to carry out their education competently. As far as the other recreation facilities are concerned, TAU offers a number of facilities for student recreation. Students can relax and enjoy within the campus by participating in various cultural activities. Texila American University is committed to making your stay in Guyana as comfortable as possible. The university offers a wide variety of safe and secure gender-wise hostel accommodation. The accommodation is offered on sharing or individual occupancy basis. It's up to you. Hostel rooms are designed to offer the best combination of comfort and facilities to the students so that they can concentrate on their studies and relax. Each room is equipped with modern facilities, modern amenities like fridge, Wi-Fi, internet facilities, laundry service, and other facilities. Canteen is available, whether the North Indian food, South Indian food, Chinese food, you can avail according to your choices in the campus itself. As far as sports facilities are concerned, TAU offers sports facilities within its campus for the students. As we all say, sound mind resides in a sound body. Living in Guyana is a delightful experience. Guyana offers one of the finest environment and climatic conditions conducive to academic pursuits, an amazing blend of the Caribbean and South America. Guyana boasts of being the only English-speaking country in South America. Now, if we talk about why Texila American University, obviously you have the questions, why only Texila American University, why not other options? First and foremost, NCI approved. It's listed in Medical Council of India. It's recognized by Medical Council of India. You have both the options after completing your 5 years of your MD program. And in both the options, we have a good successful passing ratio, whether it is in terms of USMLE, whether it is in terms of FMG exam. FMG exam is basically that particular exam, foreign medical graduate exam. If you are willing to come back to India after 5 years of your MD program education, and in India, then again, you have to appear for this FMG examination. Once you clear this, and the passing ratio is also very good of Texas American, it's almost more than 96%. Whosoever students is clearing, what I've seen in last few years, they clear in very one go itself, irrespective as compared to the other countries, basically, who provides the medical education. Clinical rotation exposure. Clinical rotation and exposure basically is nothing but, as I've mentioned, you can go for the clinical rotations in United States hospitals, which will give you a exposure to gain the international faculty, to gain the international practicals, international atmosphere in the United States hospitals, which will also help you to get through with the residency matching during the PG. And obviously, as the placement assistance, we have the clinical assistance office in the US, which helps you to get through with this PG residency matching program. Why again, if I talk about the country, English speaking country, Guyana is the only English speaking country with English as its official language. As far as other countries are concerned, they have their own local language. You have to first go through with the local language, then only you can go through with this medical education. Unless until you don't understand what the faculty is saying, what the patient is saying, what the atmosphere is saying, you can't get through easily with the course. So obviously, if it's English, everyone knows English, you can easily cope up with the country, you can easily cope up with the studies, you can easily cope up with the faculties and professors. World-class education, it's one of the top private universities with best state-of-the-art infrastructure, laboratories, libraries available in the campus. Obviously, a pocket-friendly. I'll discuss it at the end of this. Studying MBBS in Guyana, studying MD in Guyana as opposed to India, which can help you to save at least more than 30 to 40% of your tuition fees if you are getting enrolled in India into the private colleges. If we talk about Medical Council registrations, it's already listed and approved by Medical Council of India. Feel like home, would rather say 40% of that particular country population is from the Indian origin or was of Indian descent. They speak Hindi, they speak Bhojpuri, they speak Bengali, they speak Urdu, they speak every common language that is being spoken in India. Till now, any queries or questions, I would like to know if you can have in the chat box so that I can proceed further. I'll share some data about the PG residency matching and other things about the Texas American University and what are the other things going on for this current intake. So if you want to ask something about the TAU program structure or anything about studying medicine in America, you can please put it in this chat box. I hope it's you are able to understand what I'm saying and what I'm trying to explain, compare with this US and other medical colleges in and around the American countries. Now, if we talk about again the PG program, because for studying MD program in US, you need 8 years of study, UG program 4 years, then MD program 4 years. Whereas compared to the in and around region, like as I mentioned in Guyana, if you go through with this MD program, it's only 5 years. After 12th directly, you can get enrolled. There is no IELTS entrance or there is no IELTS score that is being taken. Obviously, you should be in a good condition to understand the English language. And apart from that, normal communication is required just to understand the terminologies and other things. Second thing is that if you talk about the PG program, you have the option again to become a successful doctor in the United States, to get registered and to practice in the US. If not via the bachelor's mode, then you can go with the PG mode, residency mode, obviously. If we talk about PG seats availability in US, and if we compare it with India, in India, somewhere around 30,000-35,000 seats are there. And what about the applicants? It's same as like NEET. Three times more applicants are being applying for these PG seats. As far as US is concerned, NRMP, National Resident Matching Program, is responsible for accepting application for residency matching in US from different categories of applicants as below. There are different categories of medical schools, US osteopathic medical school graduates, these are the one who applied to this PG seats, PG residency in US. Apart from that, US citizen, international medical graduates, basically US citizen who is studying in any other part of the world. And third is non-US citizen, like we Indians, obviously. If you're non-US citizen and you want to apply for the PG seats in US, I have mentioned the process you need to go through with this MD program. You have to clear the USMLE exam, step one, step two, CKCS. You need to get through with the certification of ECFMG and then you can apply for the residency matching. After completing your PG course of 3 to 7 years, you need to clear with this step three of the USMLE exam and then you get registered in the United States for practicing in US. This is the procedure for working or practicing in United States and to become a successful doctor in United States. If we talk about the data, in 2018, there were a total of 37,000 approx active applicants who applied for the residency. And out of 37,000, the position was, the number of seats for PG residency was 33,000. It's almost 1:1 ratio. If we talk about India, it's almost 1:3 or 1:4 ratio. So you, if you are willing to pursue, if you are willing to have a medical education from the world-class hospitals, world-class facilities, world-class infrastructure, then obviously you need to work hard right from the day one of your MD course. 78.3% applicants matched to PG year one positions. It's a 2018 data. And 96% PG year one positions were filled in 2018. If we talk about the numbers, these are the different basically categories of hospitals or schools. They provide the MD program in US. As I mentioned, there is a US allopathic schools, US osteopathic student graduates. These are two different kind of students. Like in India, there are BAMS, BHMS, BUMS. So obviously there are in medical schools in US also, there are two different kind of medical schools, US allopathic, US osteopathic. Apart from that, they are a US citizen who are pursuing this medical education abroad, international medical graduates, US citizen and non-US citizen international medical graduates. If you see the numbers, it's more than US citizen IMGs. 148 students got to get through with this PG residency matching in United States. Obviously, the number of positions filled in the different specialty is mentioned. 42% internal medicine, 44% family medicine, 63% students prefer to choose pediatrics. It all depends on your USMLE score, how much you have scored in USMLE step one, step two CK, step two CS, how have you performed. Then only the specialization is being provided to you for the PG residency matching in US. It's not like that you have scored good, but you need to, if you have scored a little bit less or you need to become a surgeon, you cannot go through that. It's the specialization is being provided to the students according to their score and other things. I'll take these questions at the end of this webinar. We can have a look on all the questions at the end of this. As far as non-US citizens, international medical graduates are concerned, in 2018, the ratio was 56% non-US citizens, international medical graduates got successful match in 2018. It's highest in terms of number of match. So it depends at you basically. You have to feel, are you one of them? Whether you want to go through with this US residency matching, whether you want to become a successful US practitioner, US doctor, you have to feel right now from right up. Once you get enrolled into this MBBS or MD course after 12th exam. A resident senior earns at least a 5 to 6 thousand per month, 60 to 70 thousand USD per year. It almost a normal surgeon. If you are a good surgeon, if you are a neurosurgeon or something, you can earn to 2 to 4 crores at in a year. If a normal physician is concerned, they earn up to 70 to 80 lakhs once year in a year. So it all depends. It's your hard work. It's your studies. It's your concentration towards these studies. That basically results into the earning at the end of the PG program. Now we can take few questions, then we will move ahead to this Texas American University. We are conducting one scholarship test to get enrolled into the course so that you can avail good scholarships and you can go through with this MD program. You can learn there so that you can take a route of the MD course to become a doctor in US by simultaneously getting prepared for the PG residency program. I'll take few questions in this. Pinak has mentioned, what is the eligibility criteria of HSC for general category candidate? Eligibility criteria is that, as I have mentioned in the starting itself, if you are looking for a particular MBBS, can you a little bit more elaborate? You are asking about this for MBBS in US or MBBS in and around areas like Texas American University, Guyana. As you have mentioned, what I am understanding, what is the eligibility criteria for HSC? You are asking about the 12th standard for general category candidate, basically for getting admitted into the Texila American University, you should be in a good condition of PCB marks as well as the English. At least more than 55% marks is required, but we prefer those students, as I have mentioned and I will be mentioning in the scholarships as well. Okay, scholarship will be totally based on your 12th marks, the NEET score and how you perform in that scholarship test. It's basically a minimum basic criteria. As far as Indian colleges are concerned, they don't even take the, there is no criteria by the MCI for the NEET exam appearing. NEET exam, even below 50% students also appear for the NEET exam. But as far as the Texas American University is concerned, yes, we take an aggregate of more than 55% and more than 55% in the PCB as well as good marks, at least more than 55 or 60% in English, what we consider. As far as US is concerned, in US, basically they check the 12 standards in high scoring grades. And apart from that, you need to clear IELTS exam as well as the aptitude test. You need to score good in the aptitude test, SAT test, which basically is being conducted to get enrolled for the normal UG courses in US. Kashif has mentioned, what about MBBS? MBBS, basically in India we say MBBS Kashif, and in abroad we termed it as an MD program. So it's basically a Doctor of Medicine is the same bachelor's program, which country termed it as a medicine study in that particular region, US or in and around South America or Texas American University, Guyana. So we basically we say it's an MD program, Doctor of Medicine program. I have completed 12th in 2015. Can I got admission? I got 89% in 12th. Rajat Verma. Rajat, you have mentioned you have completed your 12th in 2015, but what have been doing after 2015? We would like to know whether you have done any diploma, whether you have done any course. You have taken a long gap of 5 years. So if you have done anything, obviously it's a continuation of education. So you can mail your documents. We'll be sharing your the email ID of the university. So you can mail your documents and accordingly we can confirm. The academic committee will go through with the credentials, what you have scored, what you have done, and accordingly we can, you have done graduation, then it's quite great. Then it will be not an issue because it's not an education gap of 5 years. You are continuing your education for in between these 5 years. So it's not a gap. You can enroll, you can apply for this course. It's fine, Rajat. If there is no gap in your studies, then you can apply for this program. In the meantime, if you share your documents and according to the graduation and other things, academic committee will go through with your credentials and they will check what basically year and what studies you have done, and they will accordingly confirm you with the eligibility letter. Now, further moving ahead of the Texas American University, Guyana campus, we are conducting a scholarship test. It's Texila American University Scholarship Test of 2020. Texila American University is conducting a scholarship test for limited number of seats. Mentioned a few minutes back itself, there are limited number of seats for the Indian students. But again, there are limited number of seats for this scholarship also. So a person who is looking for these scholarships can avail up to 30 to 50% of scholarship in tuition fees. Can you imagine if a fees is somewhere around 70, 80 lakhs and fees reduces to somewhere around 40, 50 lakhs. So obviously, it's a good amount what you can avail and what you can go through with this. So first of all, you have to apply for this. Registration link is mentioned. We will put this registration link in the chat box as well. Scholarship test will be conducted in different phases on different dates. Scholarship test will be of 60 questions. Total questions will be 60, total number of questions will be 60, wherein 18 questions will be each from physics and chemistry, and 24 questions will be from bio subject. As far as markings are concerned, each correct response will have 4 marks and each incorrect response will have -1 negative marking. Exam duration will be of 1 hour 60 minutes, so each and every question you will get 1 minute. Although you all are preparing for NEET exams, so I am very much sure that you will be clearing these scholarship exams who are attending this webinar. And if you are lucky enough, you can avail this scholarship. Apart from that, these scholarships, this entrance scholarship, there are academic scholarships as well, in which student can perform in the each and every academic year, whether it is first year, second year, third year, fourth year, in the campus itself. And there are additional scholarships which they can avail in the campus. These are the additional scholarships which I mentioned. You can avail the additional scholarships, academic scholarships in the campus itself each and every year if you perform well, if your performance is at par. These are the dates in which we will be going to conduct the scholarship test for Texas American University MD program 5 years, which will start from 22nd of August, 5th September, 19th September, 26th September, 3rd of October. Days are all Saturdays. Timing is 11:30 to 12:30 a.m. It's 1 year, 1 hour examination, 60 marks, 60 questions. You have to get through this. At the end, I would only say residency matching or studying medicine in US is everyone's dream and is not an automatic progression after clinical semesters. If you think about, okay, yes, I'll complete my MBBS, then I'll prepare for. If you think you have enrolled for MBBS after 3 years, totally you are wasting your 3 years. If you are preparing for a doctor in the United States, if you have. So I was telling, it's not a one day decision that you need to go through with this medicine, studying medicine in US. It's basically a long journey you have to start after your 12th. Once you start this journey by getting admitted into the MD program or the MBBS program, you need to fulfill your dreams. And for fulfilling your dreams, basically, it's only one thing: you should start preparing from the day one of your MD course you are getting enrolled into. USMLE is not an easy task. USMLE, there are different steps. I've already mentioned step one, step two, CK, CS, certifications, matching, each and everything. University can support you, but at the end, you have to study, you have to perform, you have to become a successful doctor. We are only the promoters, supporters to you. We can provide facilities, we can guide you, we can teach you, professors can explain you the terms, conditions, each and everything. But at the end, you need to clear the examination, you need to study good, then only you will be a successful doctor. You can practice in US, and once you get registered with the US, across world you can practice. It's valid across world. Even in India also, if you are coming back after pursuing PG in India, you need not to appear any examinations by the MCI. As per the MCI, US PG is recognized. It's totally valid. You only need to register yourself in MCI. That's it. You don't need to write or clear any exam in India after clearing USPG. So I hope all of you are well prepared to go through with this study in and fulfill your dreams. In case there is any query, please, you can post here in the chat box. I'll address all the queries. Once again, we have few more minutes, please, if you can talk. Rajat, as I have already mentioned, fees basically ranges from somewhere around 65 to 70 lakhs for complete 5 years. But yes, there is a scholarship going on and you can avail that scholarship. You have done your graduation as well, you have already mentioned. Maybe it might be a little bit more reduced, but yes, it all depends on your graduation. It all depends on your credentials. It all depends on your testimonials and the scholarship test, how you perform in that scholarship test. as far as country is concerned, Guyana is one of the most beautiful countries in South American continent. 40% populations are Indian origin, and you don't have to basically do much effort on understanding the things in that particular country. You don't have to go through with any other particular language. Yes, you need to understand the Spanish so that when you are going to the US hospitals, when you are meeting to the US consultants, you can understand that local language. And in that particular thing, Taxila is preparing the students to go through with this Spanish language. They have their own classes for Spanish language, but that is only for the if you are preparing to go for the US. You have two options after clearing the 5 years MD program. Either you can come back to India again, fight for the seats like you all are doing because of this in this NEET exam. You very well know the number of seats, 70 to 80 thousand number of seats are there, and number of applicants this year is somewhere around 16 lakhs. Can you imagine 16 lakh students are appearing only for 80,000 seats? Anyone can be lucky, but at the end of the day, who are not getting the seats, I would rather say check for the options. It's much better option spending 70-80 lakhs in private colleges. It's better to go for abroad options. Go for this particular option, and where you can have your one-time investment in your graduation, MBBS, your PG will be totally, it's a kind of free studies of PG, what you are investing in MBBS. It's a one-time lifetime investment you are investing in your MD program, bachelor's program. And later on, because the stipend, the hefty stipend you are getting in your PG course, in that through that particular stipend, you can manage your fees, you can manage your living costs, each and everything. Then also you can save something. That much amount of US hospitals, US colleges are paying in the residency programs, PG students' stipends. It's a matter of only clearing or getting mindset of yourself, of your parents, just to ensure them, yes, you want to go through with this studies. Yes, you need to get through with this barrier of not able to crack through in India. It's no matter. You can get enrolled into the other colleges abroad. So, students, any other questions? I would love to answer that questions. Please, you can raise those questions in case you are having any doubts. Any other doubts related to Texila American University? Passing mark Siddharth is basically depending upon it's a whole day process. 60 marks, 60 basically, there are 7 to 8 blocks. Fine, and it's basically according to the number of blocks, number of questions. USMLE Step 3 is basically matching at the end of the program. When you complete your residency, then you appear for the Step 3. As far as USMLE 2 is concerned, CK and CS. CS is totally a practical exam. Obviously, it's under the like you all have appeared Viva and practicals in 12th examination board. So it's the same practical examinations in front of doctors, panelists, consultants. As far as the theory examination is concerned, there are the cutoffs basically same percentile basis as we have in the NEET score or PG NEET score. But yes, it's not a normal 3 hours, 2 hours duration. USMLE, if I talk about USMLE Step 2 clinical knowledge, theoretical examination, it's almost an 8 hour examination in which you will get 45 minute breaks. There are 7 blocks of 1 hour each. Each block has somewhere around 40 to 50 questions. So you can understand somewhere around 250, 260, 270 questions you need to answer in USMLE Step 2 in the whole day, 7 to 8 hours of long period with a break of 45 minutes only. Can you imagine how hectic is this for a student to go through with this a whole day examination? In India, we have only 2 hours, 3 hours examination pattern. That too only that OMR sheet, no practicals, nothing. Maybe this may change in terms of new education policy, what we are going through. Any other questions? Cost of which exam you are asking about, Siddharth? See, basically, USMLE, as I have mentioned, it's a 3 parts examination. Fine. And there are different fees for each and every. It ranges from $1,000 to $1,500 to $1,800 USD. like for step two it's somewhere around 1000 USD, for step one it's somewhere around 100 to 200 USD. So it's basically for clinical practical examination it's somewhere around 1600 USD. So obviously there is a costing and you have to pay for that. Any other questions? I hope everyone has taken this note of dates and other things. Although we will be mailing the scholarship schedule and the scholarship link to all the candidates who have joined this webinar. So there is a feedback. You can mention your feedback on your screens and have the feedback according for the webinar, for the course content, for the delivery and other things. Thanks, Abhishek. Thank you so much.